I love this guy. I got to know him over the last 4 or 5 years. And in the day, it was like, he was just legitimately one of my idols. His flow, his arm, his stance, his firm buttocks. And he still looks the exact same. Welcome, former World Series champion with the 1992 Toronto Blue Jays and a friend of ours, Kelly Gruber. How are you, man?
I'm great. Thanks, Todd. I got one thing to say. I appreciate all those nice things. However, you need to get your eyes checked.
Oh, no.
Oh, it's not all still there. I promise you. It's in different places. Don't tell anybody, though.
No, you look good, man.
Don't tell anybody. Okay. No pictures, no names on Facebook.
No, not done. We will not tweet out Kelly Gruber's butt. Hey, I have a confession to make, bro. Oh. I'm wearing sunglasses today. And I wouldn't normally do this. I wouldn't conduct an interview like this. And I wouldn't want to throw you off, but yeah, put on yours.
Feel better?
I feel better. You know why I'm wearing them?
Late night?
No, I got pink eye, I think.
Pink eye. Well, what was her name? It's contagious, you know. Don't be touching me.
I know. That's why I fist bumped you.
Atta, baby.
I was giving you respect there.
I appreciate
it. I don't know if you want to, like, I don't know. What does it look like?
Hey, it looks like 420. To me. Don't be holding that on me.
I don't know what it is, but I have a newborn, though, so maybe it was right.
Oh,
who knows?
Oh, nice.
Yeah, seven weeks old, not even.
Life is not the same.
Never it's the best.
Be. Yeah, oh, yeah, for some. And that's a good thing there.
Thanks, man.
I'm glad to hear that.
You have two, right, Kelly?
I have four.
Four? And why did I think you had two?
Well, I had four. That I know of, that I participated in. All right. And two with the marriage with my wife.
Oh, that's why.
So it's a mixed family, so there's six, actually.
That's unbelievable.
I shouldn't have to explain it. I should just be a man and say, six.
Yeah, you got six.
I had too much to explain. I don't want everybody to know my faults and stuff, right? Six, Todd.
And those aren't faults, man. That's just called these
life.
Things happen. And, you're a great dad. You're a great guy. How are things going for Kelly Gruber? What's Kelly up to these days?
Well, I don't know if you can see that. It's Innis Safety and Security. I've had the opportunity to meet a friend a few moons ago in Maritime, Nova Scotia. And his family, they're lovely people. As you know, I teach kids across Canada the game of baseball. So I spent about 5-7 years there, got to know the family real well. And he's been one of my sponsors to underwrite what I'm doing because I don't charge hardly anything for those kids. I don't want to put anybody that less fortunate out. And I accept people that can't afford the shirt on their back, okay? Well, I still got Candy Maldonado. I still got Bill Lee. I still have, you know, these guys that I want to come in that these people want to see that I know will mix in well and teach the game of baseball to Canada as it should be. And, well, you know, lo and behold, he comes along and becomes one of our sponsors, helps us pay all the, keep the costs down for the kids and enough lure meant to get these guys out of their house, you know, because they've been on the road their whole life. It's time to stay home now and be with the family and have a normal life, you know, and you got to entice them to come out. You know, most of them that I have working with me are guys that want to give their time back. But it works beautifully, guys like Sean here in his security.
Sure.
And in Halifax and Nova Scotia area.
Well, I you know, it's funny. You know, I love how, Kelly Gruber, how open and candid you are about the importance of sponsors. And we're the same way here on this program. We exist predominantly because of a lot of the people that help out the show. And once you realize that they're helping out because they're generally, some are fortunate businesses and others also appreciate what we do for them and give back and everything and create an audience and create exposure for their company. And hopefully if people are on out west, they'll go and get Anna Safety and Security. Then that's kind of how it works. But it's this sort of full circle attitude too, that you pay it forward, you promote them, they promote you, they help out, kids are learning baseball, all your former stars and idols are out there teaching and stuff. Everyone wins in these situations, and I love it because it's not like it's a hard sell. It's a family feel, and that's the most important thing, isn't it?
Well, absolutely. You know, look, I've been blessed beyond, okay, with talent and athleticism. Nothing I did. In fact, I probably abused it and didn't work as hard because I didn't have to. Huh. Well, I learned later that, come on, man, that ain't right, you know. And so with that blessing and having accomplished so much and having been fortunate to play in Canada, I don't say Toronto, I say Canada, because when we won that, we won for a nation. Atlanta thinks they're America's team. They have no clue. Dodgers, Yankees, they have no clue what it's like to play from coast to coast for an entire nation. And we did. So it's very, very special. So with that in mind, you know what? I always think to my coaches, whenever they'd give me something that was of substance, that, hey, man, and I tried it and it worked. Wow, thanks, man. I appreciate it, Cito. I appreciate it, Gino. You know, and I said, no problem, kid. Just promise when you get older and you're out of the game, pass it on down to the kids. And I feel like it's my duty. So I think it is, Todd. I think it's very important that we give back, because what goes around comes around.
Yeah.
Okay. And it helps make the world a better place. And I feel much better with myself than that, than the other.
How do people, Kelly, get involved with the camps? Where can we go online? Where can we find out information about it? How can parents get their kids interested in baseball and learning from the best?
GruberBaseball.ca. This summer we took a day off. We went 7-8 years straight and took a year off. And it's usually in the month of July. But GruberBaseball.ca. They can go online and begin to see the ones that we put on, some pictures, this, that, get an idea. And then I hope we're going to be moving. We started in St. John's, and my mission was go from coast to coast. St. John's we started. We got as far, well, we did Leaside up here, but we spent quite a bit of time in Nova Scotia area and Moncton, and we did, not PEI really, but... Because the guy that puts it on for me, Doug Jones with Louisville Slugger, that's where he lives in the valley up there, right? And he's got a boy that plays baseball. And so we found that rut and kind of started sinking in the quicksand there. I said, Doug, my mission is not to stay in Nova Scotia. But you know what? I see fruits of the labor here.
Yeah.
The year before, Nova Scotia Provincial beat Ontario first time ever.
I was going to be my next question. How are the ball players down there?
First time. Well, they weren't that good, okay, when we got there, because their coaches at such a young age are all volunteers. Bless their heart, you know, giving their time. But sometimes the worst thing you can do is teach them the wrong things. And if you don't know, it'd be like me in Austin, Texas, teaching hockey. Come on. Right?
Interesting.
Number one rule, throw the stick. No. Okay. Hit him in the head so you don't have to pull your gloves off and go to punching. Yo.
Don't worry. Yeah.
Okay. So it's a challenge for these kids. Plus, the other thing that's really against them is the weather. We play all year long in Texas.
Yeah.
California, you know, Florida. So there are not a lot of indoor facilities that cater to baseball here. So if you want a good business, call me. Well, let's get some indoor facilities.
Wow, indoor base, keep them going all year round. And that's what they're doing with hockey now, if you think about it, here in Canada, because it's the same holds true for hockey if they didn't have indoor rinks.
If we
only played outdoors, then no one would really practice the game of hockey. And now, from what I understand, kids at like 7 or 8 years old are going up to their cottages up north and putting their bags in boats and then driving to a local arena near like a Bracebridge or something to keep the training going. And that's how intense it is. And that's because if you want to keep up and eventually maybe want to be a pro these days, that's how the ones are doing it. So we should build some indoor baseball mini domes.
Hey, listen, if the kids want to, whatever they want to do, and that's their goal growing up, it's up to us to provide the tools for them to accomplish
that.
And that's what, like I said, one of the things that hinder people here in baseball is the small window they have to get better, to practice, to play it. Because it's the only way you get better is to play it. And you know, so up in Halifax, that's why we stay there too a little bit, because there's a big place where we can get indoors and I can hit balls to them.
Cool.
It's fun. My ultimate goal and the reason why I do it, Not so much for the kids, because I'm going to tell you, they don't know who I am.
Yeah.
They don't have a clue.
It's wild, eh?
It's the mamas.
Kelly Gruber's irrelevant. It's the mamas.
It's the moms and the dads. It's in them, right?
It's definitely the mamas.
Okay. Yeah. You're my agent now.
They're done.
No, but you know, you gotta help the kids. You gotta get them the tools that they need and the ability to practice and get better. I mean, that's the bottom line. And when I come up, my goal is to actually not teach the kids. We run them through their programs, but especially guys. Some of the girls are better than the guys, but the guys, they're like me, and they're probably like you guys. When I tell them something, I say, okay, great, good job, and they go around the back of the line, it's their turn next, they've already forgotten. You want to slap them, you know, this and that, but, oh, I was like that. So the key is to have their coaches and their dads that are volunteering, they're out there. They're listening because they can retain it and then implement it from day to day. And it's all done through repetition. That's what builds muscle memory.
Yeah.
Right? So that's my key, teaching the basics to the coaches so that day to day they can constantly stay upon the basics in the foundation, the small things of the game of baseball to practice on. So when you get up to the plate now, you don't have to worry about where your hands are, where your legs are, this, up, strike, the ball's by you. No, you're saying, okay, I'm looking for this pitch right here, and if it ain't there, I ain't swinging until I get two strikes. You're not worried about your hands. That will take care of itself through repetitions, and it'll just take over. You don't have to worry about it. Now you can get in the meat and potatoes of the game, have a game plan. I'm looking for this over there, over here, that. Oh, there's a guy that just took another base, so now I got to do that. And it changes. You got to stay up with it and adjust. You don't have time for your hands. You don't have time to worry about work. No. So if we can get the coaches like that, they can implement it day to day through the 10,000-hour repetition program, you're qualified to become, you're qualified as a profession. And now the dads and the coaches, I mean, look at how many Canadians are on Blue Jays.
It's crazy, man, what's going on with the, you know, you think of Russell Martin, you think, well, Brett Laurie was here, you know, playing your position, you think, well, like, there's just so many great Canadian players, but I never thought about the leadership that someone who has played the game on at your level could give. I never thought of that middle person, that middle step, which is the coaches. I always just assumed it to go to the kids. And it makes so, I've actually, and I'm pretty involved in sport my whole life. I've never once heard that. Let's make sure these coaches don't forget what we're teaching them. Because the kids these days, they'll let it go in one ear, out the other. But if the coaches have Kelly Gruber's mentality and expertise, then they will drive that point home through and through. We will see better. That's brilliant. I love it.
Well, you know, my goal, my dream is to somehow convince the government of Canada that, you know, they make these coaches that volunteer, they make them go through screening. They're not pedophiles. They're not this. They don't have a record.
Blah, sure. Blah,
blah. You don't want them out with the kids.
Not a chance, yeah.
But. Okay, so they got to go through that. Now, how about making them spend on the internet? We can put it on the internet. We can, the art of button, the basics of throwing, fielding, this, that. And each coach, two coaches per team, pay $25. You split that down the middle to pay for the cost of putting that video together and teaching the basics. And that week, they're watching it. The other half of that money goes into their league to pay for the chalk, to pay for the catcher's gear, to pay for the this, pay for it.
Now, so they're instructing.
Now they're instructing. They're getting gear. They always have to raise money for that. Well, here we go. We're doing it. And they're instructing and they're learning. So that week is baseball. Here's $50 from the two coaches. Okay, they watch it, they know, they take their notes, they go out to the field all week long. We're learning how to bunt. These are the basics of bunt. Okay, the next week, here's the coaches $50. You know, 25 and 25, yep. The two coaches. Now we're talking about hitting, or we're throwing, or we're catching, base running. Right? The basics. So that week, they're fundamentally working on through repetition, building muscle memory on just that particular part of the game. Next week will be different. Now, that's how you teach these kids to play baseball.
So, and it's programs, but it's programs that are concisely put out, sort of the program for everyone to use around the same time. And you're building that repetition, you're building the memory, and you're building the skills and the talent with, obviously, the equipment and all that stuff that you need to go along with it. Avery, so it's not just the government saying, hey, here's $8,000 you raised, you know, whatever. There's a purpose for that.
Well, yes, absolutely. And everybody's on the same page teaching the same thing. Because there's, let me tell you, my experience, and I've seen it even today.
Hey, well, sorry to interrupt. Jay Brody, we're going to have a lot of good third basemen in about 15 years if this goes through, eh?
Yeah. A whole bunch of them. Yeah.
No, I discourage people playing third. that Donaldson's over taking my cake, man. Yeah. I'm going to go Diane Kerrigan break his leg or something. I'm not sure. But no, every coach is on the same page. And in my experience growing up, and I see it again today with these young kids, because the coach, the fathers, they offer their time and volunteer to coach. Bless their heart, man. It's not a prerequisite of being a coach. Okay, so that's the void we have to fill. Now, once you get that coach that doesn't know really about the game, and he gives his time, you finish the season, you move over to your 13 now to the next season, a different coach, and you start hitting it. What are you doing? That's not how you hit. Tear him down. He doesn't know a thing. You've experienced it. Yeah. Everybody.
Every year I'm learning something new.
Is that fun?
No, it's the worst. And then you don't know. You're like, well, do I swing this way? Do I elbow up that way? That's exactly what used to happen to me in coaching. Everyone had a new philosophy.
So there's your foundation. Okay, that's what we're talking about accomplishing. Boom, there it is.
Like a baseball Bible, essentially.
Right, and here, just the foundation. Yeah, exactly. And here's the foundation the next year. You're up to here now. And the next year, there's you're up to here now. You're building, you're getting better. You're not getting torn down because he's got an ego or this dad, or, you know. So our target is to somehow make the coaches, I've done it down in Austin, go to Lake Travis Youth Association, and I have all the coaches come out. The pitcher will talk for an hour with half the group and give the basics of pitching, and then we'll be around home plate, and we'll talk about hitting, we'll talk about bunting, load, all that, and for an hour, and then we'll switch. So a total of 2 hours, and they're listening to us, and every one of those coaches now are teaching the same thing to each player. And it's got to be done every year because you got new coaches every year. Kids move up. They get older. And this dad's going to volunteer now. And that's how you build the game grassroots, as far as I'm concerned.
Well, and if you think about it, if you're put into schooling, how we all went to school, you had, with some minor adaptations and sort of some amendments here and there, but you had the same history book. You know, everyone in grade 6 had it. And then grade 7, there was an extension of that. So there were programs put into place that allowed us to grow without ever second-guessing what we already learned. And what's the point of that? That's a waste of time.
Absolutely. And you know what? Look, I don't like to be torn down.
Oh, it's terrible.
Try to be rebuilt, especially when I was doing some good things, right? Because when you do good, you feel good. You're happy. You're having fun. You want to come back and do it again. Now, when somebody's tearing you down, you have to learn something new. Don't forget, this is the hardest feat in all of sport. Hit a moving round object with a moving round object. Hardest feat in all of sports. You fail 70% of the time, you hit 300. Over here in the dome, you're an all-star. You are considered one of the best. You're getting a raise, failing 70% of the time. How many jobs out there you know?
Radio. I'll get back.
Yeah, I've been counting. Let's see. That's another.
we're still at a batting 400 here during this interview. But yeah, you're right. It's mind blowing.
I get mad. And I want to take the bat and go crack it over the pitcher's head when I, you know. But it's part of the game. And nobody likes to fail. Nobody. It ain't fun. So we teach the foundations. Every year, the coaches are teaching, and they're building this player instead of tearing him down, trying to rebuild him every year. And he never gets any higher than that. And I see it time and time. That is no fun. I'm going to go play soccer. Boring, right? I want challenge, man. Hit that moving around ball with a moving around bat. I mean, fail 70% of the time, get mad. Yeah, all of it. I do. It's a challenge, you know?
Keeps you coming back.
Well, especially when you're better each year. Mm-hmm. You're better each year. You've learned something. We had a saying in baseball in the big leagues, if you don't learn something in this game every day, you're not paying attention. And we're in the big leagues. You're supposed to know it all. We are. Now, I don't even know what qualifies infield ground rule. What is it? Infield fly? Batters out? I just catch it. I look to see, okay, he's going to run. Well, they're not going to run, dummy. Throw it back to the pitcher.
Yeah.
But seriously, there's some rules.
Little rules, yeah.
I hate rules anyway.
Yeah, well, Kelly Gruber, we love you. So forget the rules. Can you stick around and can we just talk a bit about what the Blue Jays are doing this year and compare to those 92 team that you were on? Are you in a rut? Do we have 10 minutes with you?
Yeah, absolutely.
We got some time. We're hanging out. It's wild, man. We're hanging out with a legend. GruberBaseball.com. Learn more about the it's the Silver Slugger Camp. And the Ennis Safety and Security was a big part of it, making it happen, man. And you go and support, especially if you're down east, Ennis Safety and Security. And, of course, Kelly Gruber. This is really exciting stuff. We're going to talk some Major League Baseball. And, Jay Brody, I do feel like we're hanging out with, like, the Matthew McConaughey of the major leagues. You know, like, this is one of the coolest cats of all time.
We're with a living legend right now.
And cool. He's just cool. And we're wearing sunglasses. I think he's so cool that I actually think my pink eye is cured.
No, probably got worse. Okay.
You got a diamond. You got nine men.
Kelly Gruber's here. This song ever get sick? Yes. Have you ever got sick and tired of hearing this tune?
No, not really. You know, home's a good place. Better than that Bronx at Yankee Stadium. Now that song, and they used to play that The Boys of Summer. You know, The Boys Are Back.
Yeah.
The Boys Are Back. Yeah. Every time I hear that song, because you hear that more down in Texas than this song, right? It's like, oh, man, where's my glove? I got to get ready for the game.
That's hilarious.
Oh, yeah. Every time we were back, boom, like clockwork.
Wait, is that the Boys Are Back in Town? Is that one? Hang on. Lizzie? Is it this one? Hang on. Let me see. Yeah.
Every time we came on.
You just want to start playing.
Oh, yeah. That song will fire you up.
Yeah,
and
man.
And if the boys want to fight, you better let them.
Yeah. Hey, you are our, you know, just one of these guys that's had such a connection to Canada forever. And some athletes come and go in this city, and others have just been one of those mainstays. And well, what is it that, you know, you say it's home, it's still home, and obviously your greatest years playing, we're playing here. But why keep coming back, man?
Well, you know, a couple of reasons. There are quite a few relationships I've developed that I want to continue and I want to see, obviously. I've always said it. It's probably the best big city in North America, no, beyond a shadow of a doubt. Why wouldn't you want to come? You know, and again, it's the giving back. It's the giving back, you know. A lot of people still write and send me stuff. Hey, what's going on? What are you doing? Where you been? You know, and I've been a father. I've been at home trying to fulfill daddy duties, you know. And we're almost done with that. Oh, well, I don't guess that's ever done. I don't know. But a little less trouble, maybe.
Sure. How old are the six children now? From what are their ranges from?
We're talking, let's see. One was born in 90, the next one 92, the next one 94, the next one 96. They're all 2 years apart. And we've got another 96 with my wife now. She had a 19-year-old, and Emma is the youngest. And she's 13. So
from about 25 to 13 range.
Right.
Wow.
And yeah, no door knocks. And it's your kid. This is your child. None of that. Thank God. Knock on wood.
home is still Austin, but Toronto is your second home. You have all these children. You're a family guy committed to giving back, as we just talked about, for GruberBaseball.com because of Ennis Safety and Security and because of, obviously, of your commitment with a lot of former stars. All of it, man, would any of it be worth it without family?
No, not at all. I mean, you know, it's family and you got to remember the next word that follows is team. Okay, his team. And that's how you win in life. That's how you win in ball games. You know, togetherness. You fight it as a team, because my strengths are maybe your weaknesses. My weaknesses may be your strengths. And if we stick together and we help one another, we're a team. Kick butt.
Dude, I love that. And it's about understanding who you are as a person. It's about being self-deprecating, going, oh, I can't handle paying the taxes. You do the taxes, but you know, I'll run around and get the kid at the baseball game or something. You know, like, together we can make this happen. Being a family guy, being that father, and being the major leaguer that you were, though, how was it, you know, with time? And I'm asking now as for parental advice here from Kelly Gruber, to be honest. How do you manage your time?
Well, I'll tell you, we had a jersey back in the day. It said, excuse me while we interrupt this baseball season, I think. And you had your picture of your kids on the back, or your family, or baseball. What happens is you leave. When your kids get old enough, when they're born, until they start school, they pretty much travel with you. They are allowed, with the Blue Jays, each team is different, 2 family trips that they pay for.
That's
and
amazing.
Then you have to pay for, and they have to fly different, you know, and not with you. But it's a little bit more difficult not flying with the team when your kids are small. But once they get in school, you're stuck until summer hits, until they're out of school. And then they all come up for a short time, and then they go back, right, for school when it starts. So I'm going to tell you, it's really, really rough on baseball. And that's why I promised, when I'm done as a player, I'm not going to jump like right back into the game and coach. Even though I'd like to coach and pass on the knowledge, I'm going to wait. And I did the baseball. Okay, I'm done playing. I got children, and I've taken enough time away from that. I'm going to go. I'm going to spend the time now. And then once they're out of school, and I'm gonna maybe go back to baseball and teach. So in the meantime, I'm doing my baseball camps.
Good. It's nice to hear though that, you know, that it shows the human side of a pro sports, which often we forget, especially nowadays with all the money they're getting and the fame and the glory and the Twitter followers and all this kind of stuff. But it must be tough, those moments being away from your kid. You know, I even know I got to do a Friday night club gig to get a few extra bucks, and I wish I was just home, to be honest. But I also know that the money counts too, so you gotta juggle both. Nice to hear Kelly Gruber being so real. Kelly, this run the Blue Jays are on now, man, it's got to, as a former Jay and a former World Series champion, it's got to really excite you.
Well, you know it does. I mean, to see the excitement in the air reminds me of past time. You know, and I've been up here in between, seen the difference, and yeah, it's not the same. But now, oh, it's great. I love it. You know, people seem a little more chippy, you know, and bouncing around, and everybody's got their Blue Jay hats and jerseys, and it's really cool to see. I'm real happy. I'm real happy for Cito, for Beeston. Those are the guys that came back, and I said, well, just a matter of time. Just please be patient. Rome wasn't built in a day, right? And look, every year they've been here. So even if we were to drop out of the playoffs, not make the wild card, accomplishment this year is exciting. Okay. Now, it's okay to expect better things for next year. Maybe win it. Well, maybe the next step be getting in the wild card, getting in the playoffs. Not winning. I don't know. But you see that step. Every time, every year, they're done with the game, with the season, and it's better. And I'm really happy for them. I'm really happy for the fans. You know, they're excited. It just makes the place different.
Oh, the whole city, the whole country. That's the nice part about the Blue Jays is we can be sort of impartial because everyone is supporting them. I have to ask, one of the things I thought was weird this year was we all knew that Paul Beeston was retiring at the end of the year. We already knew that. I wasn't sure why the Jays had to announce who their new president was going to be in the midst of all of this. This Mark Shapiro guy from Cleveland. I didn't understand why we had to do it. Could we not have just waited to the end of the year until we announced someone new and not break up the goodness that we have right now?
That would be nice. You know, because to be frank with you, I'm a little worried about what everybody's going to do. Let's say these guys go ahead and win the World Series. And what? Beeston is gone? And we don't ever know the truth, mind you. Retirement, fired, we don't know. Okay, anybody can say anything, and I've heard some things that's happened while I wasn't here. And I just don't think that Beeston is going to retire. Maybe from the Blue Jays because of what they've done to him. Maybe. I don't know. I wasn't there. I didn't hear. It's just what I hear. But if they win it, Cito and Beeston are gone. And I don't even want to think about it. What would the city do? I mean, how do you do that to the champion? Well, you know, in comparison, they kind of did it to us when we won in 92. They released or traded 12 of us.
Wow. Yeah. Why? I mean, granted, they won in 93, but it's so strange. Yeah, it's so weird for me to always say Kelly Gruber, 1992 World Series champion, and not follow that with 93. I forget. Like, you forget that you just weren't a part of that because you were such a major force for the Blue Jays for years.
Well, I can't tell you how many since that happened. I can't tell you how many letters I've gotten that have flat out just told me, said, you know, what happened? Where are you at? What's going on? I don't understand. I will never, ever go to a Blue Jay game again. Wow. And I thought about collecting all of them, which I did, because I was seriously thinking about taking them up to the Blue Jay office and say, here, you guys, man, yeah. I don't know if you care the bums in the seat or why, but, you know, there's a few of them that you might be able to. But, you know, that's the nature of the game. It's business.
Yeah.
It's business. That's why I never represented myself. That's why, I want to keep it a game. I don't want to be influenced by negotiating my contract over here and having them tell me, well, you know, you don't do this well, you don't do that well. Well, we ain't going to give you this, and breaking you down. Because your job is, well, my stats are as good as Corny Lansford, Gary Gaetti, Wade Boggs. I mean, right there, you know. Why aren't I getting paid? That's how you negotiate, the art of it.
Yep.
You place yourself in the market fairly. Well, their job is to tear you down. So I'm going to go. They win. I'm going to go down to third base, and there's a ball. It's hit hard down the line. I move for it. And I split second, I think. Wait, what did they say? Oops, sorry, I couldn't get it.
We're not getting paid for it anyway.
And unfortunately, that's human nature.
Yeah.
I don't want that. Mm-hmm. Even though I had a desire to learn the business side of the game, you know, the art of negotiating and whatever. But, you know, I just put it aside and I said, nope, this is a game for me. I love playing the game and I want it to stay a game.
Good for you. Good for you. And, you know, I personally always say that a player in any sport deserves as much money as they can get at any given point. And some will argue, how do you pay these guys millions? How do you give them retirement packages before they're 27? You know what? They're the top 200 or 300 in the world at what they do. And I would say that to anyone who is the top 200 or 300 in the world at what they did. If you're the top, surgeon in the world, that guy should be a multimillionaire. And you know what? If you're the top landscaper in the world, so should you.
Absolutely.
And that's the way I've always felt. So if you can negotiate those deals through leverage, through comparisons and stuff and do well, give it to the athletes because it's not an easy life, man. And you know, it's not all roses. And especially for guys who did it 20 years ago, do you ever have resentment seeing the type of money that people get now? Or just more envy, like, oh, I wish I played now.
Yeah. Well, it's all relevant, of course. You know, we had the old timers come into us, and we were making the kind of money we were making. It was a lot, okay?
Yeah.
All relative.
Yeah.
Back in the day compared to back in the day for them. Well, today, back in the day, has moved up to now the guys, and that's nothing. So, you know, the sport is growing, and but it is tough, Todd. We've talked about the family,
yeah.
You know, and that's number one, you know, as far as it's over baseball to me, you know, my family. And you got to deal with that being apart. It's very, very, very hard, especially little bitty, you know, and you just miss them. And you know how your mind is on it. It's hard to concentrate sometimes. It's like, I need to see my baby. I need to see my girl. I need, you know, And it's hard. So it's mind over matter. It's being strong, doing what you have to do, and get back and spend as much time as you can before you got to get back over here and do what you got to do.
Sure.
You know, and it's tough. You got 162 games in 175 days. That's just regular season. That's not including the playoffs, the World Series. That's not including spring training. There's another 30 games. 1 year I counted 225 games we played. In the year.
That's a lot of games, isn't it, Broadster?
It's way too many games.
Oh, we need a raise then. That's it. That's bad. It's done. You hear that, beast?
It's too many games.
You hear that, beast? And the other thing is, how about this? How about you get on a plane? Well, there's jet lag. Mm-hmm. There's altitude change. And then you get to the hotel. Different bed you're sleeping in every third day. Different diets.
When you travel, because whenever I travel, which isn't like twice a year, I got to blow like my nose to pop my ears, just to start hearing correctly after a day again. Does this happen when you travel so much?
Absolutely. And you know, all the change, you know, what it does and what it does to your sinuses like that and this and that. When your sinuses aren't right, you're dizzy. Your equilibrium goes. And it's like, holy cow, I'm trying to hit this ball on a ship in the middle of the ocean. You know, it's hard enough. But you have all those things that people don't, you know, they make spaghetti different over in New York than they do over here, than they do in Boston. And simple dish. But what does that do to your insides? The changes, you know, of regularity. At the very least, so all.
Well, if I don't have my 8:30 in the morning dump, my whole day's thrown off. So I'm being serious. I can't imagine what it's like to every day being a new routine because I like the same. I need the same routine.
Well, we had a little bit of advantage. You sit behind the desk here, at least out there. If you pass that 8:30 mark and then you're out on the field, all you need to do is dive. And it'll come out. But that's only on the road because those are grays. You don't want the tidy whites, man. But, you know, it's like New York. Honest to God, you don't order room service with your name. You always go under aliases. David Wells, what was he? Peter Gozinha.
Peter Gozinha.
That's awesome.
I was craving Moorhead.
Yeah.
So, okay, but there's a reason for this, okay? There's a reason. It's all Boomer's fault, okay? I didn't think of these. It's when you order and you say, oh, this is Kelly Gruber's room. He's calling. He wants room service. Blah, blah. Okay, what would
sausages.
You like, Mr. Gruber?
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, no telling what's it. But as soon as you eat it that night, you go out to the ballpark and just run.
Wow.
And bookie's calling you on the phone saying, hey, this is John Elway, man. Can you leave me a couple tickets or something? Are you guys doing all right? How's Steve? He's pitching tonight, right? He's feeling good. He's got his arms going and everybody's ready. I'm really looking forward to it. Yeah, two for John Elway, please. And it's a bookie trying to get the scoop.
Get out of here.
And then room service trying to give you the runs.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Whoa. Anything for a win. Those are fans.
The 12th man.
Yeah. That's insane. Yeah.
And plus they would throw AA, AAA batteries, quarters from the upper tank. Wow. And they would whiz by you, hit the ground. And it's like, you dig? How about that fart sunk in the ground? I said, hey, Olerud, give me that hard hand. Borders, you don't need that catcher's gear. Give me that. Man, I'm telling you, it's dangerous, right? So these are some of the things that you have to consider, that wear and tear. And listen, Rance Mullick said it the best. We broke camp every time. And he said, remember, boys, this is a marathon. It is not a sprint. 162 games in 175 days. The dog who shits quick don't shit long. What? What is that? What's dog shit? What? What did he say? Swear. And after a while, you get it. You get it. So now it's 2 hour dumps for me.
Yeah, you have lots of
unless
time.
I'm in a hurry. Yeah, it's a sprint.
Well, I mean, these stories, it's so cool to hear from you, Kelly, who lived it and experienced it. And I mean, it was the greatest time, without a doubt, in Canadian baseball, what you went through in 92. My father called me out of Carlton. I was at that first game ever in 92, and then I just remember that ride, and I remember what it did with the community, bringing us together on Yonge Street and everywhere and high-fiving and hugging people you didn't know. There was nothing like that time, and this year it looks like we're getting close to it again. And despite maybe some of the problems with you and the organization in the past, you still must be very excited, right?
Hey, man, listen, bygone's bygone.
Yeah.
Okay, and ifs and buts or candy nuts, we'd all have a Merry Christmas. Okay, I don't play all that. I say what I have to say. I get it out. Once I do, I'm done. I'm over it. I don't care how they take it. No, it's how I feel. Listen, it's much more healthy to get it out, you know. And the truth hurts a lot of times. Most people can't take it. But once I get it out, I don't care what it comes back. I feel better.
Dude, we park our cars in the same garage because I'm just a direct person, but then I'm over it. And it doesn't mean I'm a monster after that. It just means, that's what I felt, and let's go on. Let's go have a beer.
Well, judge not, and he will not be judged, right? Treat people how you would like to be treated. I mean, just the small things like that, you keep right there, and you practice that. And life is short, man. And this life is not perfect. What's on the other side? Nobody knows. Do I believe in ghosts? I've never seen one, but I'm not going to say no. UFOs, aliens? I don't know. I'm not going to say no. So my mind's open. I know you're the same way, and that's why your karma is where it's at. That's why you're who you are, successful and happy, and you know, and you move on. Like you said, you just you learn and move on. And grudges, I don't have time for. You know, I don't have time for suing. I don't have time for grudges. Okay, I feel better. Bye. You know, and that's my suing. That's how I sue them. That's, you know, that's my regret or you know,
revenge. Your vengeance. Yeah, yeah. That's just my revenge. Whatever.
But you get it out, and that's what it's all about. Listen, baseball, okay, it's all about communication. Communication, okay? And life is all about communication. And when you hold it in and you're running for that ball and they're running for that ball and neither of you call it and boom, you collide, and right?
And that's what happened to Tulowitzki.
And the other side of the coin is I assume he's going to get that ball. We're both running at it. Oh, I assume he's going to get it. He's assuming I'm going to get it. And we both stop, and it falls right in between us. Well, how do you spell assume? A-S-S-U-M-E. You make an ass out of you and me. Never assume. Communicate. This is how I feel, you know. It's one of the things I love about my wife so much is Mapuana. She is a boy. She is tough. I'm going to tell you, brother, she is. And she will let you know how she feels. Okay. But, man, after that, it's like it never happened. You know, it's that person over there that, like, they may get mad at you and do some underhanded whatever. I don't. But they remember it, and they keep doing it, and they keep doing it, and they keep doing it. Revenge, right? You know, get it out, get over it.
Like that. Life's too short, man.
Yeah, so. You know, baseball is a lot like life, and, you know, teamwork is where it's at. We all need help, and we all need to give help. And, you know, baseball has been very, very good to me. and so it's my duty to give back. It's my duty to teach these kids of Canada. I could do it in Texas. They got good coaching now. It'd be like somebody coming from here, Dougie Gilmore.
Sure.
He's not really needed to coach up here to these kids. You guys know how to play hockey. He needs to come to Texas. The only ice we have is in our glass, right? We damn sure ain't skating on that or fighting for sure. But baseball, this was my market. This is my form. And this is where it's needed.
GruberBaseball.com, making Canada better, making great baseball players, and hopefully guys that one day will play for the Jays or represent Canada, who's doing so well as a whole, as a nation, when they're doing all these different sort of, whether it's Olympics or that type of stuff, and all That's these right. types of competitions. Kelly Gruber, we could sit, you're one of those guys that almost wish we were just having a glass of carnivore and sitting and talking for hours with a campfire or something. Yeah. You're just one of those dudes, man. Your words resonate, and your presence and your energy, and I wish people could feel it here in the studio. You get chills, don't you, Jay Brody? Just listen. It's like a lesson from Tony Robbins when he can play baseball.
This guy's he's a legend. I've had your bobblehead on my nightstand for the last 20 years, and if it could talk, it would weep uncontrollably.
I had no idea I had a bobblehead. Are you serious?
Oh yeah, you do.
They never gave me one.
We gotta get Kelly that. We gotta Kelly that bobblehead. I know you got to run, Kelly. You're doing some press. You're in town for a week.
Well, actually, we're going up to Ottawa for a charity event on Thursday, coming back on Friday, and then I think Saturday, Sunday, heading up to Halifax to. I think we're shooting a commercial here for Innis.
Great.
And then I fly back the 30th, I believe, and then the 1st I go back to the house.
Well, if there's an opportunity for some reason where we have a buddy from TicketPartners.com who gets his hand on a lot of tickets or boxes and things, maybe what we should do is a Todd Shapiro Show special with the one and only, the legend himself. I'm still saying the best third baseman Toronto's ever seen until Donaldson maybe wins one, Series for us.
Oh, he's a good one.
He is a good one, isn't he?
That's a compliment.
Okay. But I mean, I'm saying you're the number one. You still won that World Series for us. Yeah. We should do a special where we get you to a game with some listeners and we crush it and that might be a little fee. It's Kelly Gruber, right? But we get in there. Like let's all go together. I gotta try and figure out something.
That would be fun. I appreciate that. That sounds fun. I'd rather go to the campfire with a glass of carnivore.
Maybe we do that actually. Okay.
I love fires. I'll stare at it all night. It's like cable TV. I don't have to pay for cable nor electricity, nothing, just stare at it.
And you breathe well.
Absolutely. Outdoors. It's...
Wow. Right. Well, Kelly, you become a friend to me, and it's I'm the guy who's always in awe still. I tell every guest this that I meet that I watched or saw on TV or whatever, and it's I'm living my dreams, and I'm hoping that we as a program here, we can represent everyone to live those dreams vicariously through us, because we just approach stuff as friends and fans. And if you're a friend and if you're a fan, life is so much more complete, and I'm both of yours. So thank you very much for everything you've given us.
Thank you, Todd, because what you just said, that's why I'm here. It's the word.
I appreciate it, man. Well, I really do. Kelly Gruber, go to GruberBaseball.com, and thanks to Ennis Security. They're out east. Go and check them out. And they're helping Kelly in the baseball camps. Go Blue Jays, go. And you're talking to, or you've been hearing anyway, from one of the greats, Mr. Kelly Gruber himself. Thank you again for your time.
Hey, what's up? I'm Roddy. Subscribe to our channel. You're going to love it. For the rest of this episode, you got to check out our podcast online on the website. Go check it out. You won't be disappointed.